Broad River in the East Kimberley area of Western Australia, scene of a huge project which includes two dams and an irrigation area of up to 200,000 acres. Mechanical excavators and bulldozers are reshaping the land in an ambitious project which will cost nearly £20 million. The first stage, now well underway, comprises a diversion dam here at Bandicoot Bar. Already there's a pilot farm in operation. It grows rice with the aid of irrigation channels through what was virgin country a year ago. Ron Kinsey, who comes from the Riverina rice fields, looks at the first rice produced on the Ord River, rice which can be exported to the teeming millions of Asians not far to the north. A huge new market for Australia. State finals of the New South Wales primary schools bring budding champions to North Sydney Olympic Pool, and some keen barrackers too. It's only 2 years to the next Olympic Games in Tokyo. Maybe some of these youngsters will be swimming for Australia. Anyway, there are plenty of records toppled, so future prospects look good. Between races, the champions of tomorrow limber up, ready for the big moment when they'll face the starter. Others keep warm a different way. Today, the girls take the honours, and in this race, there's a triple record breaker. She's 10-year-old Deirdre Pearson of Rockdale, and she's already broken the 10-year-old 33-yard freestyle record and the junior butterfly record. Now watch her in the 55 yards junior freestyle. It's another record as she swims the distance in 36.7 seconds. With the best swimmers from about 300 schools competing, Deirdre's performance is really something. Deirdre Pearson, only 10 years old, but she may be another Dawn Fraser.
Aftermath of a sunrise explosion in Kentucky. The center of a chemical plant in Brandenburg is a mass of wreckage following a blast that demolished nearby houses and rattled windows in Louisville, 30 miles away. One man of the 19 who were rushed to hospitals has died, and two others are in critical condition. Fortunately, only a handful of men were on the job when a 10,000-gallon tank of ethylene oxide blew up. Otherwise, the fatalities would have run high and the damage been far more than the estimated $8 million loss.